overall, it was a much... For me, it was shot better, and it did put a smile on my face where the other one did make me cringe, but I think you missed the whole kind of antiseptic-y, you know, the kind of importance of why the tissue was different.
And let's not forget the antibacteriality of it. You skated over damagingly. Jo, you deal with lots of advertisers. What did you make of I Love My Tissue?
Well, I mean, I have to say first, I'm still in shock. I mean, for you, I thought you were going to win the series, so I just can't believe it. But that's... I think that compared to the other team, when I saw that name, my heart kind of sunk a little bit for you because, love it or hate it, the A Tissue just had that sort of hit you between the eyes quality that I think Sir Alan loves. So even at that point, I think the idea was kind of like lost a little bit.
But all Alan wanted was the pack shot. He wanted a great big screen-filling picture of a box of flipping tissues, and he didn't get it. Well, I know Rafe's frustration. Do you really need to hit the public right between the eyes with something like that?
Well, no, I don't think you do. But I think in this case, you were launching something, so something that would explain what the product was would probably have been more helpful. And even though the other ad was creatively really weak, at least it had a product point. I mean, there's something, you know, there's a thing about the advertising task, I think, in this series, is it seems that all of your commercial sense flies out of the window. So rather than sit round as a team and say, OK, you know, what are we going to say and what's the interesting idea and who are we going to say it to, everybody couldn't wait to get behind the camera or design the pack. And because you had no idea at the heart of it, I think it proved really tricky.
I think you're absolutely right. I think me and Michael, you know, for, you know, 15 hours thought we were the next Fellini stroke Pasolini. Pasolini. We just got carried away and...
But all he needed was one bloody shot of the tissue. You had it. You just plonked that in.
I had it. And, you know, and obviously I had the overall say, so I'm not passing the buck. Michael deemed it to be vulgar.
What's so bad about that? You know, it's a...
In the editing suite, we just looked at it and we just thought, my God, the audience are not that stupid. They know we are, you know, advertising a box of tissues. It was patronising, and I didn't want to, you know, I didn't want our piece of advertising to come across patronising.
Have you been a fan of Sean Lloyd's for some time? In love with her, was it you or Michael or both?
I think it was mutual admiration for Sean Lloyd's. I think we both obviously had this hidden fascination that was outed during the series.
I don't know what peculiar sexual picadillos are getting on here. You think in love with each other and in love with Sean Lloyd's? Hey, Sean's here. Sean, thanks very much for coming. One awful moment. I thought you were going to be dropped from the advert, and your career would never have recovered from that. And you seemed bewildered, as everybody else was, by your selection.
I was puzzled as to why I was there. Rafe, I thought you'd use a weather reference, like, come rain or shine, whatever the weather, you know, with the tissues. But can I say, Rafe was a dream to work with. He really was. And he could teach a lot of people in our industry as to how to deal with people. You were brilliant.
Thank you so much.
You really were.
Thank you.
Let's examine the other ad. Now, if yours was bad, this was truly... Can we think of an adjective? Shit. Can we say it? Let's just say it.
Are you OK, sweetheart? Chris!
What's the matter?
Well, she's not well. She's excited about school. But what about the other children?
Well, don't worry. These newer tissue are antibacterial. It'll be fine.
Chris, she's not well. Are you sure?
Don't worry. A tissue are antibacterial.
Come on. You are the sunshine.
You must have thought you absolutely had it in the bag when you saw that, surely.
When I saw the A Tissue campaign, I was going to fly off my seat just rejoicing before even Sir Alan had told us what the results were. And Sir Alan said, what do you think of the other campaign? And I said, in no uncertain terms, pretty much pants. I think that just irritated him even more.
Nick, what did you make of that one?
Well,
theirs was better. Come on, give him that.
No, I think I'm going to stick to my guns that both were pretty dreadful. I mean, everything about that second ad was depressing, wasn't it? I mean, I thought that the box was depressing, the cast, I hope they're not here tonight, but they were pretty depressing. The setting was depressing, the dialogue was awful. So it just goes to show that even if you've got a product point that you want to get across, you need to try and do it in an engaging way, and that one clearly failed, I think.
But they did get it right between the eyes, sort of between the legs, if you like. Bam.
Between the legs?
Yes, well, yeah, look, that was about as subtle as a kick in the bollocks, wasn't it, at the end, when they showed the box at the end. And yeah. You need to do that with a new product.
Yeah, well, hopefully you try and do it with a bit more wit and charm. But, yeah, I think that the trouble with I Love My Tissues is you'd have no... there'd be absolutely no reason why you'd want to buy it.
Now, I know, Louise, it doesn't match the decor in your house, which is the important point, but what's your general view on the advert?
On this particular one? I thought it was just naff, actually. But I have to agree with Nick. If, you know, there was bullet points that needed to be said and made and put across, and that advert did do that. And even though I did feel it was a bad ad, and I did much prefer yours, they did kind of nail it.
Jo, could this appear something like this? Could that possibly appear in your magazine, a board like that?
It's just, I think Lucinda made a great point. It's just the vulgarity of, like, when actually the last thing you want on a pack of tissues is somebody blowing their nose. You actually don't want to be reminded that it's about snot, do you, at the end of the day.
What about this one? Which would you bet was sort of more likely to appear in your magazine? Well, this one of Rafe's or the other one?
Is it wrong of me to say the thing about that with the line, this is the start of a beautiful relationship, as a parent I'd be quite worried about that. I mean, where's that going? So that kind of struck me as well.
You and Michael. Had that been this love affair? Did it start early on in the series? Would you like to see it? Or did it just blossom in this show?
I think it gradually blossoms. I think, you know, myself and Michael shared, you know, a lot of this amateur dramatic background. And. And we, you know, we got on. I mean, he, you know, I was suddenly annoyed. He kind of exhibited his Judas moment in the boardroom when he suddenly turned against me.
Could you have expected anything else?
Do you know what? I honestly didn't expect that, and I was just, you know, it was like a stake through the heart.
Let's look through the journey of your love affair. We've got plenty of tissues here, if anybody wants to have a little cry. Here's the stage we all know so well, the falling in love stage.
I think you and I have both been in Guys and Dolls, haven't we?
That's correct, yeah. I was Sky Matterson.
And I was Benny Southstreet.
This is a motion shot, and you're scoffing away. And
never thought I'd. Why are you going to do a task here, mate? I
you were so close that in the cafe scene where you knew you'd lost it, you were making all